हेलो एवरीवन, आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू केयर वेलकम सीबीएसई स्कूल मुदौर ऑनलाइन क्लासेस। इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी डिस्कस्ड 10th प्रॉब्लम ऑफ एक्सरसाइज 8.1। सो ट्राई टू सॉल्व रिमेनिंग वन प्रॉब्लम, 11th प्रॉब्लम ऑफ एक्सरसाइज 8.1। एंड टुडे आई विल कंटिन्यू विद ट्रिग्नोमेट्रिक रेशियोज ऑफ सम स्पेसिफिक एंगल्स। सो टुडे वी विल डिस्कस ट्रिग्नोमेट्रिक रेशियोज लाइक साइन, कॉस, टैन and cosec, sec and cot. These trigonometric ratios of some specific angles. Here some specific angles means with respect to 0 degree, 0, 30 degree, 45 degree, 60 degree and 90 degree. So today I will discuss these trigonometric ratios with these specific angles means 0, 30, 45, 60 and 90 degree. So first we will start from trigonometric ratios of 45 degree. Trigonometric ratios of 45 degree. So here they are given one triangle ABC, ABC, and here angle B is 90 degree, and here they are given in page number 182. In triangle ABC, right angled at B. So here it is right angled at B. If one angle is 45 degree, then other angle is also 45 degree. So here, if this angle A is 45 degree, then angle C should be 45 degree only. Why? By angle sum property of triangle. You know that sum of interior angles of triangle always equals to 180 degree. Okay, so here if it is 90 degree, angle B is 90 degree, and any one of these two angle equals to angles equals to 45 degree, then other angle should be 45 degree only. See here, one angle is 90 degree and another angle is 45 degree. What we will get? 90 plus 45 means 135 degree. Okay. So now, if sum of two angles equals to 135 degree, then remaining angle should be 180 minus this 135 degree, which is equal to 45 degree only. So by angle sum property, if one of the angle between these two angles, if one of the angle is 45 degree, then other angle should be 45 degree only. So here, angle A equals to angle C equals to 45 degree. So here in triangle ABC, what they are given? In triangle ABC, angle B equals to 90 degree because right angle at angle B, and here angle A equals to angle C equals to 45 degree. These two angles are 45 degree. So now we can write that BC equals to AB. They are given directly here BC equals to AB. Why BC equals to this BC equals to AB? We know that opposite sides of equal angles, opposite sides of equal angles are equal. So here you can see angle A equals to angle C. This angle A equals to angle C. If these two angles are equal, then you can say that opposite sides are equal. So opposite side of angle C is AB and opposite side of angle A is BC. Therefore, this BC equals to AB we have written here. Okay? So here, what we can write? Opposite sides of equal angles. So now let the considered here BC equals to AB equals to length A. BC and AB equals to any length A. So now by Pythagoras theorem, what they have written here, AC square. So we got length of BC and AB. We considered these two lengths as A only. Okay. So now we have to calculate length of AC. How to calculate? By Pythagoras theorem, AC square equals to AB square plus BC square. So here, AC square equals to length of AB is A, therefore here I will write A square plus next length of BC, is A again, therefore here BC square means I will write A square. So AC square equals to A square plus A square means what you will get? A square plus A square equals to 2A square. Okay, but here we have to calculate length of AC. So AC equals to here square root of 2A square. Here it is square, therefore equals to 2A square. Now we are calculating length of AC equals to, when we are not considering this square value, then here we should consider square root, of 2A square. Therefore, AC equals to, what you will get? Square root of A square is A, and here I will write square root of 2. We don't have perfect square value, so here we will write A square root of 2, because square root of A square is A, and we will write remaining value square root of 2. So AC length is A root 2. So now we got the all the values. AB is A, BC is A, and AC is A root 2. So now we can calculate all the trigonometric ratios with respect to 45 degree angle. So here, if this is 45 degree, then I will consider this as perpendicular, and this is base, because opposite to theta, perpendicular, adjacent to theta, this is base, and this is hypotenuse. So now we know that always sin theta equals to perpendicular by hypotenuse. So here, length of perpendicular is A divided by length of hypotenuse is A root 2. So A by A root 2 means what you get here? You can cancel A and A. So that what you get here? 1 by root 2. Okay? So now we will see cos 45. Always cos theta equals to base by hypotenuse. So here base length is A and hypotenuse is A root 2. So now again you can cancel A and A. What you get? 1 by root 2 only. Okay? So now tan 45. Tan 45 equals to, always tan theta equals to perpendicular by base. So perpendicular length is A and base length is A. So what will get here? A by A means you can cancel A and A. What will get? 1. So now Again, we will calculate another trigonometric ratio, cosec 45. So we know that cosec 45 always equals to 1 by sine 45. This cosec 45 degree or cosec theta is reciprocal of sine theta. So that I can write here cosec 45 equals to 1 by sine 45. So here 1 by, what is sine 45 value here? 1 by root 2. So what you will get here? Root 2. Okay? Or directly you can write here cosec 45 equals to 1 by sine 45, means this cosec 45 is reciprocal of sine 45. So reciprocal of 1 by root 2 is root 2. You can write it directly. Or see here, if you take this root 2 upper side, so what it becomes? You should consider reciprocal. So root 2 by 1 means root 2 only. Okay, so now another reciprocal of cos 45, now sec 45. This is reciprocal of cos 45. So now what I will write? 1 by cos 45. 1 by cos 45. So here cos 45 value is 1 by root 2, means for sec 45 value should be root 2 only, because this is reciprocal of cos 45. So now remaining one is cot 45. So I will write it here. Cot 45 equals to 1 by tan 45, because this is reciprocal of tan theta. Cot theta is reciprocal of tan theta. So what we got here? Tan 45 means 1. So reciprocal of 1 is 1 only. So cot 45 is also 1 only. Okay? So here these are the trigonometric ratios with respect to 45 degree. Here, this is triangle ABC where angle B is 90 degree and one of the angle A is 45 degree. If one angle is 45 degree, if one angle is 45 degree and one angle is 90 degree, then another angle should be 45 degree only. It means this angle C should be 45 degree only by angle sum property of triangle, because sum of interior angles of triangle always equals to 180 degree. So here what we got? Angle A is equal to angle C, which is equals to 45 degree. If these two angles are equal, then opposite sides of these two equal angles are also equal. So opposite angle, opposite side of this angle is BC and opposite side of this angle is AB. So BC equals to AB. And we will assume that length of AB and BC equal to A only, any length A, because these two sides are equal, therefore we will consider only one variable A. So by Pythagoras theorem we will find out length of AC also, because here length of AB and BC equal to A. Now we will calculate length of AC by using Pythagoras theorem. So what we got here? A root 2. Length of hypotenuse is A root 2. So now we got all the values, all the lengths of three sides. So here sine 45 equals to perpendicular by hypotenuse, means what we will get? Perpendicular is A and hypotenuse is A root 2. So here you can cancel A and A. What we will get? 1 by root 2. Like this only you can continue. You will get all the values of trigonometric ratios with respect to 45 degree. Now I will continue with trigonometric ratios with respect to 30 degree and 60 degree. So now here trigonometric ratios of 30 degree and 60 degree. There is one equilateral triangle ABC
Let us now calculate trigonometric ratios of 30 degree and 60 degree. Consider an equilateral triangle. This is equilateral triangle ABC. Since each angle is an equilateral triangle is 60 degree. If this is equilateral triangle, then all the interior angles should be 60 degree only. All these angles are interior angles are 60 degree. Therefore, what you can write here? Triangle ABC is an equilateral triangle therefore what we can write here angle A equals to angle B equals to angle C equals to 60 degree okay so now draw the perpendicular AD from A draw perpendicular AD from point A to the side BC so this is perpendicular AD to BC so here I will write draw AD perpendicular to BC so therefore here they have given triangle ABD is congruent to triangle ACD they are given that triangle ABD this triangle is congruent to triangle ACD these two triangles are congruent why you can see here these two angles are equal because we know that angle ABC all these angles are equals to 60 degree so here we can write the triangle ABD and triangle ACD what we know angle B equals to angle C both the angles are equals to 60 degree and here angle ABC equals to angle ADB equals to angle ADC ADB equals to ABC these two angles are 90 degree because AD is perpendicular to BC and again this AD is common to both triangles you can write AD equals to AD it is common in both triangles so that we can write therefore triangle ABD is congruent to triangle ACD these two triangles are congruent so that they are given BD is equals to DC these two sides are equal BD equals to DC and angle BAD equals to angle CAD these two angles are equal why because of CPCT angle BAD equals to angle CAD BD is equal to CD and these two angles are equal because of CPCT so below this they are given triangle ABD is a right triangle right angled at D with an angle BAD equals to 30 degree and angle ABD equals to 60 degree so here you can see now here in triangle ABD this is right triangle where angle D is 90 degree in triangle ABD angle D is 90 degree and here this angle ABD this angle is 60 degree and remaining this angle is 30 degree why it is 30 degree here you can see if this is 90 degree and this is 60 degree 90 plus 60 180 means this should be 30 degree only why because of angle sum property of triangle always angle sum of a interior angles of a triangle always equals to 180 degree so 90 plus 60 150 remaining angle should be
30 degree only. So this is equals to 180 degree, means this angle should be 30 degree. So here I will write in triangle ABD, here is angle ABB, angle B is 60 degree, angle D is 90 degree, and remaining angle BAD, this should be 30 degree only by angle sum property. Okay. So now, as you know, to calculate trigonometric ratios, to calculate all the trigonometric ratios, first we should calculate lengths of the all the sides of the triangle. So here first we should calculate length of the triangle, sides of the triangle. So first we consider length of AB. Let AB equals to 2a, or you can write it as, if AB is 2a, BC and AC, AB is equal to BC is equal to, and remaining side AC is all equal to 2A only. Why? This is equilateral triangle, means all the sides are equal. Therefore, we will assume that length of all these three sides are equal to 2A. So now, here in triangle ABD, first we will calculate length of this BD. BD equals to, we got here length of AB, this is 2A, we assumed here AB is equals to 2A, and now we are calculating length of BD. So BD is half of the BC. BD equals to half of the BC. So here 1 by 2 into BC length is, here BC length is 2A, 1 by 2 into 2A. So 2 2 cancels, what will get? Length of BD is A. Here I will write A, length of BD. So now we have to calculate length of this AD. By using Pythagoras theorem, we can calculate length of AD. So here, this AD square plus BD square is equals to AB square. AD square plus BD square equals to AB square. So here, now we are calculating length of AB. Because we got length of AB as 2A, length of BD as A. Now we are calculating length of AD. So here, AD square equals to AB square minus, I will move this BD square to right hand side, so it becomes minus, therefore minus BD square equals to length of AB, we considered as 2A, therefore here I will write 2A whole square minus length of BD is A, therefore what we will write here, A square. So what we will get here, 2a square means 2 to the 4, so 4a square minus a square means a square only, a whole square means what we will get, a square. So 4a square minus a square means what we will get, 4 minus 1, so 3a square. This is the length of AD square. Now we are calculating length of AD, means what we should write, AD equals to square root of 3A square. 3A square. Therefore length of AD equals to square root of 3A square means what we get, A root 3, because square root of A square is A, and we will not have perfect square of root 3, therefore we will write it as it is only, A root 3. So length of AD is a root 3.
So now we got the length of all three sides. Here AD, AB equals to 2A and BD equals to A and AD equals to a root 3. By using these values, now we can calculate all the trigonometric ratios. So here I will write now trigonometric ratios. First one, sine 30 degree. Sine 30. So sine means we know that always sine equals to perpendicular by hypotenuse. So here this, if this 30 degree is considered as theta, then opposite side is this BD, then this is perpendicular and this is hypotenuse, and adjacent to theta this is base, AD is base. So now here sine 30 equals to P by H, perpendicular by hypotenuse means what you get, length of perpendicular is A here and length of hypotenuse is 2A. So here A by 2A means you can cancel A and A, what will get, 1 by 2. So next, cos 30. Cos 30 means you know that base by hypotenuse. Base by hypotenuse. So what is base value here? A root 3. A root 3 divided by hypotenuse length is 2a. Now we can cancel a and a again. What do we get? Root 3 by 2. This is cos 30. Next, tan 30. Tan 30 means perpendicular by base. So here perpendicular length is a and base length is a root 3. So that you can cancel a and a, what you get, 1 by root 3. Okay. So now by using these three ratios you can write cosec 30, which is reciprocal of sine 30. So 1 by sine 30. 1 by sine 30 means this is reciprocal of sine. Cosec is reciprocal of sine. So reciprocal of 1 by 2 means reciprocal of 1 by 2 equals to 2. Like that only. Next, reciprocal of cos 30 is sec 30. So 1 by cos 30 equals to reciprocal of root 3 by 2 means what will get? 2 by root 3. Next, cot 30. This cot 30 is reciprocal of 1 by tan 30. So here tan 30 value is 1 by root 3. Reciprocal of 1 by root 3 is root 3. So these are the trigonometric ratios with respect to 30 degree. Now we will see trigonometric ratios with respect to 60 degree. So here I will write trigonometric ratios with respect to 60 degree. Now, reference angle theta changes. Here, if sine 30 means this is theta, this angle is theta. But now we will write trigonometric ratios with respect to 60 degree means theta is angle B. Okay, so here perpendicular is AD and base is BD and hypotenuse is AB. So now again sine 60 is equals to perpendicular by hypotenuse.
Their perpendicular length is a root 3, a root 3, and hypotenuse length is 2a. So now you can cancel a and a, what you get? Root 3 by 2. So now next one, cos 60. Cos 60 is equal to base by hypotenuse. What is base here? Base is BD, length of base is A, and hypotenuse length is 2A. So A by 2A means you can cancel A and A, what you get? 1 by 2. So now again we will consider tan 60. So here tan 60 means always tan 60 is equal to perpendicular by base. Perpendicular by base. So perpendicular length is a root 3. A root 3. And base is a. So that you can cancel a and a. What is remaining? Root 3. So tan 60 equals to root 3. Now cosec 60. This is the reciprocal of sin 60. So sin 60 means what we got here? Root 3 by 2. So that cosec 60 equals to 2 by root 3. So now next one, sec 30. Equals to, sorry, here sec 60. This is the reciprocal of cos 60. So what we got? Cos 60 means 1 by 2. Reciprocal of 1 by 2 equals to 2. Now remaining one, cot 60. Cot 60 means this is the reciprocal of tan 60. This is equals to tan 60 value, what we got here? Root 3. So reciprocal of root 3 means what you will get? Reciprocal of root 3 is 1 by root 3. So these are the trigonometric ratios with respect to 30 degree and 60 degree. So what we did here, we considered one equilateral triangle ABC. If this is equilateral triangle, then all the interior angles are equal to 60 degree only. So if all the interior angles are 60 degree, now we will consider one perpendicular line AD. So that this ABD is congruent to ACD, because these two angles are equal, because 60 degree only, and this is common. AD, side AD is common in both triangles, and this AD is perpendicular to BC means here these two angles are equal, 90 degree only. So these two triangles are congruent. If these two triangles are congruent, then these two sides are equal. So now BD equals to CD. Then you can say that BD is half of the BC. BD equals to half of the BC, because what we got here? BD equals to CD. Next, after that what we did? We consider length of AB as 2A. If this is 2A, then we know that BC should be 2A only, because all three sides are equal, therefore BC should be 2A only. So that BD equals to half of the BC means what you will get? Length of BD is A, and by Pythagoras theorem you can calculate length of AD, which is equals to A root 2 by Pythagoras theorem. So that you got all the values of the all three sides. And here, if this is 90 degree and this is 60 degree, then remaining this angle should be 30 degree only by angle sum property of triangle. So now, after this, you can write trigonometric ratios means sine, cos, tan, cosec, sec, cot with respect to 30 degree. After this, again you consider this 60 degree as theta, again you can write trigonometric ratios with respect to this 60 degree. So try to remember these trigonometric ratios with respect to these particular angles. Means today we discussed trigonometric ratios with respect to 45 degree and now trigonometric ratios with respect to 30 and 60 degree. Try to remember these values, sin 30, cos 30, tan 30 or sin 60, cos 60. Try to remember all these trigonometric ratios with respect to particular angles. So in next class, I will continue with trigonometric ratios with respect to 0 degree and 90 degree. Thank you all.